The investigation into Bland's death, can you say where it stands now? What part of the process is it?
Where we are, I would say at this point, the major pieces of evidence which are being analyzed at this time are Ms. Bland's cell phone, and also I've asked for the Rangers to take a hard look and do forensic testing on the garbage bag that was used to hang Ms. Bland. And I say that in the event that she hanged herself, she was hanged by someone else, because I believe that will be very telling who, if any's DNA is on that garbage bag, specifically the knot that was tied in the garbage bag.
The Houston Chronicle is reporting that according to intake papers that she filled out when she was taken into custody or brought to the holding facility, that she indicated previous suicide attempts. Can you confirm that? Are you aware of that?
I have been advised that by the sheriff's office. I've actually seen that paperwork, and it does appear that she indicated to the sheriff's office that she had tried to kill herself at least once. I believe she indicated that was with pills. I don't believe there was any indication on there as to what kind of pills it was.
Do you know then if in a case like that, that would raise some red flags, that would alter the monitoring of somebody in custody like that?
Anderson, I don't want to sit here and claim to be an expert on jail policies and procedures. You know, I'm the district attorney, I'm a prosecutor.
Sure.
But from a common sense standpoint, I would think that that would be something that, of course, would be important by jail commission standards when assessing an inmate for potential care once they come into the control of the jail.
Well, Elton Mathis, I appreciate your time. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.